Behind me, as you can see, the pilgrims begin their sacred pilgrimage. But the shrine they seek is not Mecca or Mashhad, it's Memphis, Tennessee. And the object of their idolatry is not a centuries-old prophet, but Elvis. Elvis Presley, who seems to be becoming more of a cult figure now, even than when he died 3 years ago. A private charter for the annual trip to America's Deep South. For the 350 members of the Elvis Presley Fan Club of Great Britain, the beginning of a great adventure.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. In the next few moments, two of your tour escorts, Mo and Mercedes, will be coming along to collect a collection for you for a floral tribute that we're going to place in the Graceland grounds on the 16th of August. We don't want you to go overboard, we'll just give $1 or $2. Thank you.
A gentle request, but the fans will find that where their idol is concerned, almost everything has a price.
What is it about Elvis? What makes him so terrific?
Well, everything. To me, I think he's what every chap wants to look like in real life, and what every woman wants for her husband, I should imagine. And I think that's what makes him. And you can think a lot about him, and just feel great, you know, that is fantastic. It's a fantastic feeling.
Is this your first trip to
my very first trip? I couldn't afford it before, and I've waited for years and years and years for this, and this is my life.
This is a pilgrimage for us every year, and we've already booked for next year.
Really?
Yes, we're in already.
Not Mecca or anything like that?
No, just to see Elvis's grave. Unfortunately, we've never seen him live, but he lives forever for us.
He rules my life. He rules my life. My life revolves around him then.
Unfortunately, my husband can't stand him, so he sent me off to Memphis and he went to Malta.
There's something about him. You can't put it into words, it's just a magic, if you like, yeah.
Physically he's dead, but I mean, he proves this today by this pilgrimage here. I mean, he's not dead. His music would never die. I mean, he'd be bigger than Valentino ever was in 10, 20 years' time. He's the sort of man you could look up to.
You can't. You can explain.
Who do you love the most, Elvis or your husband?
I can't.
What would you like to do while you're on this trip? Do you have any ambitions?
I have a white Elvis suit that I had made in England, and I do a little bit of singing like Elvis. I'd like to sing, if possible, one song in Graceland's in the house of Elvis's.
What song would you choose? How does that go?
Please don't break my heart in two. For I'm not made of wood, and I don't have a wooden heart. If I knew that I would cry, maybe I would. There's always you. I may be the deadliest choice.
After 20 years, he still dresses Elvis, cuts his hair Elvis, speaks Elvis, and sometimes feels deep down inside that maybe he is Elvis. And despite appearances to the contrary, he's totally happy.
Heartbreak Hotel was recorded at Elvis's first recording session for RCA. What was the date of that session?
1956.
1956? Can you give us a month?
Pardon?
What month?
What month? Oh, pass. Oh.
anything that you want to do. Honey, lay off my shoes.
In the opinion of the clapometer, the winner was David Fennessy.
The ritual climax of every evening. Last thing before going to bed, the fans sit hushed and absorb the song that says it all for them. With the pain or the memories, as you can see, etched in every face.
I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing. And now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, no, not me, I did it my way. Oh, what is a man? What has he got? Not himself, and he has not. To say the word, he truly feels. It is the word, the word he feels. The record shows, I took the blows.
Seven a.m. the morning of the third anniversary of Elvis's death. The fans are up to buy flowers to carpet Elvis's graveside. Their tribute, $300 worth of roses and carnations sprayed red and shaped like a heavenly guitar.
With a hole in your heart, and you
even at the most solemn moment in the Elvis celebrations, the cash keeps rolling in. Even a memorial service is organized as a business venture and charges the fans already spending millions of dollars every year in the city $5 a head to get in.
So this morning, a memorial service, it's a tribute to Elvis Presley. It isn't a salute to death, but today, musically, a celebration to life. And we thank you for having come.
As a memorial service, it all seems somewhat ersatz and manipulative. The music was distinctly mediocre, and the sentimentality shallow and calculated. But it was enough for the believers. When it was over, they returned to the Memphis sunshine, refreshed by it all. Finally, the fans make their way to Graceland, Elvis's home and last resting place.
As I told you, Elvis purchased Graceland for $100,000 for his mother. He wanted her to have all the grandeur that Graceland offered. But unfortunately, Gladys, his mother, did not get to enjoy Graceland very long, because early in 1958, Elvis was inducted into the armed forces. He was sent to Fort Hood, Texas for his basic training. And he packed up his daddy Vernon and his mother Gladys and took him out to Fort Hood, Texas and rented him a beautiful house out there. Now, who do you know other than Elvis Presley who would take his mother and daddy on basic training, huh?
Keep on. Army life changed your mind about rock and roll?
So did Army life.
No, it hasn't. It doesn't change my mind because I was in tanks for a long time, you see. And they rock and roll quite a bit.
Today, across the way from the gates of Graceland, it's been renamed Elvis Presley Boulevard, a whole glittering fairground full of shops and stalls selling hollow relics to the teeming tourists.
Y'all should decide to get any souvenirs. Y'all find them a lot cheaper at the first store this side of the laundry. That's where a yellow coupon goes, but the store of the flags right on there on the corner.
Well, we're here just opposite Graceland, but even here, the still small voice of the cash register can be heard. Actually, can be heard pretty definitely, in fact. We've got here some things that the team have gathered from around the place, and some of them are just sort of plain ludicrous. I mean, if I was Elvis, I don't know that I would want to be remembered with a rubbish bin. I mean, that wouldn't have been my first choice, and I hope someone will take a note of that. But this is a rather unusual guitar. It doesn't play very much, but it plays a merry tune on the cash register, about £6. Then there's the things here that are just sort of amazingly priced. This is a towel, which in England, I guess this quality of towel you could get for £2, and you have to decide whether the design is worth the difference, which is from £2 to about £6. Maybe with this design you'd say it's worth, you know, £1. Anyway, there are frisbees here. Now, frisbees in New York cost a dollar. Last time I bought a frisbee, I don't do it all the time, but last time I did, a dollar. These are $2.25, these frisbees. Now, plates, Royal Dalton, Wedgwood, they can be damned expensive, and this one is $10.95, but that doesn't sound, you know, like a Royal Dalton or a Wedgwood to me, and it comes in at $10.95, which, in other words, at the current rate of exchange is about £5, very nearly £5. And here are one of the mugs that you can buy. But since the price of this particular mug is $9.95, again, between £4 and £5, it's clear that the purchases as well are intended to be mugs into the bargain. Well, bargain probably is an inappropriate word, actually. Now, to be fair, I suppose if you look around the world at the religious shrines of people all around the world, you'll find shops that attempt to sell things, cash in on the devotion of the faithful. You'll find that all over the world. But there's a difference here, and the difference is a simple one. It's this, that in the case of the founder of one great religion, in any case, he threw the money changers out of the temple itself. In this case, alas, it's very clear that the money changers are very much in control, still, inside the temple. Well, now, you're all about to go into Graceland right on this Memorial Day. We'll come over with all of you, because it looks as though you've got to queue up for a little while, doesn't it?
God bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you.
The fans come from all over, from Japan, from Canada, from Australia, and from England. There's an Elvis Presley fan club in every major city in the world. 600 in America alone, and over 50 branches in England. On this day, the privileged faithful flock here to Memphis to visit the gravesides. The gravesides of Elvis and his family. For all of them, he means something special. Beth was right. He touched their lives.